A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, no need to recall the past, no need to think about what was done before. See, I am doing a new deed. Even now it comes to light. Can you not see it? Yes, I am making a road in the wilderness, paths in the wild. The people I have formed for myself will sing my praises. Jacob, you have not invoked me. You have not troubled yourself, Israel, on my behalf. Instead, you have burdened me with your sins, troubled me with your iniquities. I it is, who must blot out everything and not remember your sins. The word of the Lord. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Happy the man who considers the poor and the weak. The Lord will save him in the day of evil, will guard him, give him life, make him happy in the land, and will not give him up to the will of his foes. The Lord will help him on his bed of pain. He will bring him back from his sickness to health. As for me, I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. If you uphold me, I shall be unharmed and set in your presence forever, evermore. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, from age to age. Amen. Amen. A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, if a swelling or scab or shiny spot appears in a man's skin, a case of leprosy of the skin is to be suspected. The man must be taken to Aaron, the priest, or to one of the priests who are his sons. The man is leprous. He is unclean. The priest must declare him unclean. He is suffering from leprosy of the herd. A man infected with leprosy must wear his clothing torn and his hair disordered. He must shield his upper lip and cry, unclean, unclean. As long as the disease lasts, he must be unclean, and therefore he must live apart. He must live outside the camp. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are my refuge, O Lord. You will fill me with the joy of salvation.
You are my refuge, O Lord. You fill me with the joy of salvation.
Happy the man whose offense is forgiven, whose sin is remitted. Oh, happy the man to whom the Lord imputes no guilt, in what spirit is no guile. But now I have acknowledged my sins. My guilt I did not hide. I said, I will confess my offense to the Lord, and you, Lord, have forgiven the guilt of my sin. Rejoice, rejoice in the Lord. Exult, you just. O come, ring out your joy, all you upright of heart.
You are my refuge, O Lord. Give me the joy of salvation.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Whatever you eat, whatever you drink, whatever you do at all, do it for the glory of God. Never do anything offensive to anyone, to Jews or Greeks or to the Church of God. Just as I try to be helpful to everyone at all times, not anxious for my own advantage, but for the advantage of everybody else, so that they may be saved, but for the advantage of everybody else, so that they may be saved, take me for your model as I take Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel of Christ.
A leper came to Jesus and pleaded on his knees, "If you want to," he said, "you can cure me." Feeling sorry for him, Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him. "Of course I want to," he said, "be cured." And the leprosy left him at once, and he was cured. Jesus immediately sent him away and sternly ordered him, "Mind you say nothing to anyone, but go and show yourself to the priest and make the offering for your healing prescribed by Moses as evidence of your recovery." The man went away, but then started talking about it freely and telling the story everywhere, so that Jesus could no longer go openly into any town, but had to stay outside in places where nobody lived. Even so, people from all around would come to him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Old Testament made a link or a connection between physical sickness and sin. And in the first reading at Mass this morning from the book of Leviticus, we see how that terrible affliction, leprosy, was considered a sign of impurity according to the law of Moses. Leprosy was the most obvious sign of God's punishment, and its contagious nature, at least at a certain stage, rendered it the worst possible death, because it was a living death. Lepers were unclean. They were separated from society. They were forced to live in poverty and isolation. And to cure a leper would be like raising someone from the dead. And anyone who was healed from this disease was obliged to present himself to the priest and acknowledge his sins. To touch a leper, on the other hand, made the person who touched him unclean themselves. But our Lord not only challenges the link between sickness and sin, but he also reaches out and touches the leper. In the Gospel this morning, we are confronted with the faith of the man afflicted. If you want to, he says, you can heal me. And Christ does want to heal him. Jesus is filled with tenderness. The Jerusalem Bible translation is a bad one. It says Jesus felt sorry for him. That is not what the Greek says. The Greek of St. Mark's Gospel says that Jesus was filled with tenderness, or moved with compassion, is another translation. As he reaches out to the leper and cures him. And this is a sign of the kingdom of God, of the coming of the Messiah, of the Christ, the anointed one, who himself identifies with outcasts. And yet our Lord wishes his coming among men, his coming on earth, to be recognized for the right reasons. He is the Savior who will suffer and die for the world, and who will be raised on the third day. Jesus isn't some five-minute wonder worker. He directs the leper to report his healing to the priests because he wanted the religious authorities to recognize the coming of the kingdom. But our Lord is also keen to avoid publicity because he doesn't want that five-minute adulation. He seeks a response of faith. And Jesus seeks to heal all who are sick, not only in body, but also in soul and spirit. And spiritual healing does not depend upon physical healing. Sometimes people are not healed physically. They continue in their sickness. They die, as one day we will all die. But the spiritual healing, and as a priest I can testify many times have seen this, that a person is healed even though their body may not be, their spirit, their soul, their mind, their emotions, particularly forgiveness. Sometimes when people are sick and even ending their life, nearing the end of their life, they're very much aware of a need to forgive and to be forgiven, to be reconciled, perhaps with a family member. And by God's grace, this happens, that they let go, particularly when they receive the sacrament of the sick and confession. Spiritual healing does not depend upon physical healing. And we who are sinners, we must recognize both the compassion of Christ and our need of a deeper healing, of interior conversion, the forgiveness of sins. Just as leprosy separated the leper from society, in the same way our sin separates us from the body of Christ, the church. It separates us from God and others. It also separates us from our true selves. And this is why Jesus offers us forgiveness in and through the ministry of the church, in the sacrament of reconciliation, penance, going to confession. Because Christ, who is the sinless one, he touches, as it were, our sin through this sacrament. And that's why it's essential that we go to confession regularly. Now, perhaps in recent years, some Catholics have forgotten this. Perhaps some priests have forgotten to preach about the sacrament of confession. But whatever the case may be, it is never too late to return to our Lord's mercy and forgiveness. And we should never become complacent, accustomed to sin. That's why an examination of conscience, a placing of our lives before God in prayer, is important. Every day, especially at night, when we say our prayers before we go to bed. And God will bless our humility and our courage. Lent is upon us. Wednesday is Ash Wednesday, the beginning of Lent. And Lent is a wonderful season for making that commitment to examining our conscience and going to confession. The stream of grace in confession, our Lord's outpouring of mercy and forgiveness. Because Jesus has come to set us free. And when we experience, when we taste that freedom, we too, like Jesus, will welcome those whom other people consider unclean. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for Bishop Allen, and all the bishops, that they continue to work for the unity of humankind.
Lord, be on us. Receive our prayer.
We pray for those who are overwhelmed by pain, including spiritual pain. May they find the comfort and support they need. Pray for those who are called to be compassionate in a special way, that they find their strength in God. May we believe in life and live it to the end.
Lord, hear us.
Receive our prayer.
We pray for all our sick, especially Father Victor Camilleri, Colin Smith, Philippa Anya, John Crandall, Tom and Betty Morgan, Simos Pepe, and Gemma Faulkner. We pray for all who have recently died. We pray for Luchita Nebria, who died on Friday. We remember all our family members and friends at this time. We remember all those whose anniversaries occurred this week. We pray especially for Father Donald Mills, Father John Gareth, Father Charles Nell, and Father John Joyce. May they all be with the Lord in his kingdom.
We pray for the person soul of our mighty Father, whose funeral was on Friday, and Father John Peel, whose funeral being admiral on Tuesday. May their souls console all the faithful departed, bring us in
We ask Mary, our mother, to join with us in our prayers as we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
In silence, let us place before the Lord all that we carry in our hearts.
Let us give thanks. we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Amen. Thank you. As Father mentioned, I am Sister Julie. I am from India. Today, I am here to make the annual mission appeal on behalf of the Sisters Mission Committee of England and Wales and of my own congregation, the Sisters of St. Peter Claver. We are very grateful to Fathers for giving us this opportunity. The Missionary Sisters of St. Peter Claver is an international religious congregation. Since its beginning until today, thanks to the generosity of numerous benefactors and friends, it has been a source of support for missionaries in the poor mission countries. Our patron saint, St. Peter Claver, lived 40 years of his life as a missionary in Colombia. He served the slaves who were imported in the colonies of the newly discovered Americas, restoring them to their dignity as God's children. The life of St. Peter Claver moved our mother foundress, Blessed Mary Teresa, to leave her high position at the court of Tuscany in Austria. She committed her life fully to prayer and mission promotion. By making known the struggles and difficulties of the missionaries to the fellow Christians of her time, enabled her to raise a rich harvest of spiritual and financial support for poor missionaries. Today, they continue to inspire us to assist missionaries engaged directly in evangelization. Today's scripture readings shed light on our own call to believe and follow Christ. Jesus calls each one of us to go out to bring God's love and mercy to others, beginning from our own families. Christ's love for us is able to change the human heart and to bring peace to our troubled world. This morning, standing before you as a missionary, I would like to be the voice for the missionaries who have taken the supreme honor of presenting Christ in words and deeds in the poorest parts of the world. First of all, we encourage you to pray for the missionaries, especially for those who are working in difficult and poor parts of the world. Pray for the missionaries for strength and perseverance, especially when they face difficulties and persecution. We encourage you to support the missionaries in their work of evangelization. We sisters receive many requests from missionaries from poor countries, asking for our help for evangelization and human development. Today, I would like to draw your attention to one of the many requests that we have received. It is from Sister Selma, from the Religious of Jesus and Mary in Timor Est. She is asking help for empowering young women from poor villages with educational programs. It is to help to provide secure environment to equip the young women with functional literacy skills to enhance employment and livelihood opportunities, and also to deepen the faith formation. They are very grateful for any help you may give and assuring you of their grateful prayers. Echo from Africa and other continents is our newsletter with the stories of the missionaries. Subscribing to this newsletter will be a way to remind you to help the missions whenever you can through the year. There are sample copies at the exit door, and also the booklets of our Mother Foundress and our patron saint. Please feel free to take a copy of it. Their love and zeal for the mission are really inspiring. There are also gift aid envelopes available if you wish to gift aid your donation. The sacrifices you make to reach out to others, both materially and spiritually, are the very works of God, guided by the Holy Spirit to heal the world. Thank you very much for your attention and support today. You are in our prayers and in the prayers of the missionaries. Asking God's blessings on each one of you, let us pray. Lord Jesus, as the Father sent you into the world, so you sent us to show all people your love. Let our hands be your hands, our words be your words, so that we may give your love to everyone we meet and help to spread this love to the ends of the earth. Amen. Thank you.